And welcome to the Naio Nails Channel. We are filming from home because we're working from home. And because of everything that's going on at the minute with the pandemic of COVID-19, which I'm not very happy about, but neither is everybody else, we are muscling through. There's loads of like GIFs and things like that and stickers and things that you can put on your social media. So one that's really popular at the minute is the stay at home little sticker you can put on your Instagram feed. So we thought we'd do it on a nail.
Well, you thought you'd do it. I had no idea what you were even talking about.
Yeah, I thought I'd do it. I've had to explain to Adam what it even is.
I'm so not down with the kids.
Well, you know, one day. You can't be good at everything.
I'm on TikTok now.
Which is amazing because I'm obsessed with TikTok.
And I quite enjoy it. It's really fun.
It is fun, especially at this time in our world, how everything's crap.
When we're bored out of our minds.
Yeah. So we've discussed a few ways of doing this. We talked about doing an ombre in the background and then filling in with the white. And then we talked about actually doing the shape with the gel polish and ombre in the actual lines. We felt like the easiest way for you to do it is to do the ombre in the background. So that's what we're gonna do. I have got an ombre brush. Where is my ombre brush? So this is the Naio Nails ombre brush that's been ripped trashed. I may have trashed that a little bit.
It's been used well.
Yeah, but the brush is fine. The brush is still fine. So it might not just look as pretty, that's all. So what we're going to do is I've picked some colours to go with the logo, and we have these pretty colours, and they are 961, Adam.
961, let's Google that.
We've got a glass and a half, which is a gorgeous purple, like Capri's purple, and then we've got like a pinky purple, which is called Pitch Purple.
So that's called Royal Blood.
Royal Blood, this one is.
Yeah, it is, yeah. Do you think they are blue? Do you think they bleed blue, the Royals?
Maybe. And then you've got 967. What's that one, Adam? 967.
That is called Hawaiian Lei.
Hawaiian Lei.
Is it L-E-I, Lei?
Well, a lei is the necklace, the ones made out of the flowers. The necklaces right, that we wear out of the...
But is that how you say it, a lei?
A lei, yeah. I have several leis in my camper van. It's like totally a camper van thing.
Sorry, that sounded like you said you've had several leis in your camper van.
I've not even had one, actually. Times are hard. Right, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to start with my dark colour at the top. Now, as we look at the design, if I like have a little look on here, so here we are, you can see we need it in a short space. Yeah, so we're going to create the design on here in the centre of the nail. So we need the ombre in the centre. So that's going to be the most difficult part, is creating that ombre in the centre. Unless we do it this way. Actually, that might work better. So I'm going to start with my blue here. Because you've got to think about what's actually going to show. What's going to show through. And I'm going to put my palest colour here. And you'll put them on more than your other ones. So they are covering more of the nail, if that makes sense. Then what I'm going to do is take a little bit of the glass and a half, and also, oh, we're back. Are you there?
Yeah, you keep coming and going.
Okay. So we're going to put this one here. And I'm using a detail brush for this. And I'm going to clean my brush. And I'll go into pitch purple.
Are you doing a vertical ombre?
Yeah, did you not, were you not here for that discussion?
No, the camera keeps cutting out. So you're doing it sideways?
Yes.
All right, I thought you were doing it like the heart. Right, okay.
So I'm going to pull through from top to bottom. And then I'm going to tap to encourage the colours to mix. And then same again here. Tap. So tapping it with the bristles of the brush will encourage the colours to blend. You can see it's coming together. And then here. I'm having to sweep these a little bit more because they are so different, just to really get them to blend. I'm going to turn this around. And I'm going to use the brush to come through the centre. And sweep. And again here. And then we're going to do two layers of that. I'm going to show you the other way as well. So again, we're going to do the majority blue at the top. And then our pink at the bottom. Get a little bit further down with that blue. Which is a glass and a half. And then we're going to use pitch purple, which pitch purple is like a pinky purple. So with this way, if you do it this way round, you're going to go into the blue and start to tap side to side, and you will start to merge the blue with the purple and the paper brush, and then we're going to come from the purple into pitch purple. So we've got a glass and a half going into pitch purple, which is slightly more pink. Clean my brush, and we're going to go from this colour, which is pitch purple, into pink, the brighter pink, and we can do two layers of that. We'll build up colour. So let's go back to our original vertical ombre, and we're going to repeat. Sorry, small child in the kitchen.
Not so small these days, though, either.
Right, so we've got the colours on again. We won't need to tickle as much, we can drag through. Drag, 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 clean. And you can see that adding that second layer perfects the ombre. And we're going to do the same with this one. So you can see when you're doing a vertical ombre and a horizontal ombre, it is slightly different techniques. So I'm loading my colours on. Now you could do this to do your ombre. Some people find this way a little bit easier. So it's kind of the same technique as doing the vehicle. I've got a brush in my mouth. So, or you can do it the other way, which is tapping and teasing.
I think I've seen you do it every way possible. Like you've done them so many different ways over
the years. Whatever is easier for you. It's just because it suits somebody else doesn't mean that you necessarily get used to that technique easily. So it's whatever technique you find easy. There is no right or wrong. Right, I think because these colours are very, very different, I think doing it this way will help blend it better. And now I'm going to go and tap. So we can even use a combination of techniques. Oh, if you want something to watch, if you've got like preteen and teenage children, I started to watch Lock and Key. It's really good.
Oh, I've watched it. It's good.
It's really good, isn't it? You can watch it. You can watch that with preteen kids.
Yeah.
And teenagers.
Yeah, it was fun.
Yeah. I don't know what the rating is on it. It's probably 15. I don't know, but
no, it'd be like a 12A. I think it's nothing. There's nothing really.
Yeah, it's a bit scary at times, but like intriguing. It intrigues you, doesn't it? It reminds me of something I would watch as a child. Right, so I am going to matte top coat this now. And I know you're a bit thinking, well, why are you doing that? Because I want the gel polish to stick really well. And I'm gonna use white. So what I want is, I want the gel to stay put where I put it. I don't want it to slide on top of that sticky layer. So I think, you know, in my head, obviously I haven't done this before, but I've done similar things. I do think that this kind of technique will work a lot better for this design. I'll tell you what, top tip, if everything goes a bit pear-shaped with the ombre, what you do is you can get from the Aurora collection, these have like loads of like shimmer in them, but they're still transparent. Naio do many different colours in the Aurora. So this one is Solar Wind. It's better than Ass Wind. So this is, it's shimmery. We can put it on nice and thin so we can still see colour through the shimmer. It's gonna add nice shimmery sparkle, and it's also going to hide any imperfections. I am still gonna matte top coat our shiny one. I want you to see what that looks like, because yes, it's nice shiny, but when it's matte it does look a bit gorgeous as well. Now time for the fiddly stuff. So we're going to use the white, which is Snow White, obviously. And if you notice, it's actually very similar to the Instagram colours. But Instagram's got a little bit of yellow at the bottom. Okay, so we have our colours. Very, very similar. If you look at it, yeah, I think I've done all right there with the colour match. So we have the white. What we need to do is figure out exactly where the heart's going to go. So we're going to kind of sketch. So you don't need a lot of gel polish at this moment. You just need a little bit on there just to help you sort of sketch out. You could even draw this out in pencil. So we have this little house shape. That's going to help me figure out how big I'm going to go with the heart. I kind of want it to fill most of the nail. I want to take this a little bit lower. Brush with a little bit of gel residue wipe off solution just to remove that. So I'm going to go slightly lower with that. I need to leave the gap for that chimney. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim chimney. I love Mary Poppins. So I'm roughly gonna just go around here. I will neat him up after. La ba 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 ba. Getting them equal is the hardest part. So you need to be thinking about what part's going to be white, what part's going to be ombre. Someone's either got a really loud lawnmower or a really loud drone outside.
Really? I can't hear anything.
I would imagine that it's actually a lawnmower. I don't think people would be flying drones. Although I did think, oh my god, how amazing would it be to have a drone right now?
And just go and fly over.
Yeah, and see like how
empty everything
is. Yeah, how empty it really is. While that's in the lamp, I'm going to paint this nail white. Because this will be the now that says, stay home. Don't be a dick, stay home. Like, why are people going out? I mean, I understand some people need to go out, but why are people going out when they should not be going out? Being very naughty.
Yeah, I mean, did I go out the house yesterday? I don't think I did. I think it's been 2 days.
I went out yesterday and went on to get some exercise because I've had zero exercise for about 5 days. So me and Cassidy went out on his skates for about half an hour. Just went to the shop and back. Thought, well, we'll go to the shop, we'll get... we were out of bagels and out of Philadelphia, which Alicia lives on at the moment. So yeah, we got that. So I'm working on it bit by bit, and I will cure as I'm doing it. My closed jaw polish does not dry until it's cured, and I don't want to mess it up. So I've just buffed over it to smooth it before I put the next layer of matte top coat on. I like to do this just so it really smooths everything out. I'm going to do the same on this, especially when you're using gel polish, because it's a little bit thicker than paint. So I like to just give it a little buff, and it'll just make everything a little bit more smooth when I apply the next layer of matte top coat. I'm going to clean them over with gel residue wipe off solution. beautiful. Bit of ombre. Obviously sending out a cool message, a really good, meaningful message that you need to keep your ass at home and stop spreading the virus around to everybody. I know it's hard because, I'm not going to lie, I'm struggling. I am. Mental health's not the best, but got to think about everybody else, the vulnerable people, and keep your ass at home.
Definitely. I'm quite happy to stay in the house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not. So there you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today will be listed below. So keep playing with nails and try to relieve your boredom. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.
See you later. Oh, can you hear Isaac there?
What's he saying? Singing.
But why? Obviously, Haley's telling him not to do something and he's just lost it.
But why?